All right, well, welcome back, everyone. Thank you, Christian Brinkoff, for letting me substitute guest in here. I'm not that Christian, I'm the other Christian, Christian Montoya, but I'm really excited to show you some follow-up exclusive content from Episode 6, Windows in the Cloud, Windows 365 Enterprise with Azure AD Join Support. So in this specific, episode, I'm going to show you a little bit more of how you can use Azure AD Join on your own network, aka the on-premises network connection. So let's jump in. So here we are on our Windows 365 portal experience in Microsoft Endpoint Manager. So we'll go over to the on-premises network connection. And this part will look slightly new. Previously, you would only have a regular create button, and you'd be creating a hybrid Azure AD Join network connection. But instead, you now have an option. So as you see, Azure AD Join is in preview, so we're gonna go and select that. So here's the experience for the Azure AD Join network connection flow. If you had previously created one for hybrid Azure AD Join, you'll notice that all you have to enter are network details and then you go on and create. You don't have to add in any domain join details. And that's the brilliance of it. That's why it's so simple, is that as soon as we're talking straight to Azure AD and doing the join with Azure AD, there's no more reliance on the on-premises infrastructure on your Windows Server Active Directory. So we don't need a domain or an OU or join credentials. All we need is that network that we'll create the Cloud PCs on, and then we can get started. So again, for this section, it'll be very simple of which network do I want and what do I want to name it. So again here, just like in the hybrid Azure AD Join network connection flow, we just choose a subscription and resource group for where we're going to create those NICs, the network interface card objects, and then also the virtual network and the subnet of where those Cloud PCs will be provisioned. And after that, we just go straight to review and create. Again, a brief blurb that if Windows 365 doesn't already have permissions in the Azure subscription, this flow will go ahead and coordinate that. So I could go review and create. I'm going to exit out real fast. And I want to show you the slight differences also, not just in the creation flow, but in the ongoing network checks that we do as part of the network connections. So you'll see here, I have a couple Azure AD Join and hybrid Azure AD Join. So let me actually first go to hybrid Azure AD Join. We're going to have a lot more checks here because again, the Windows 365 service is doing those checks to make sure your domain is ready and the Cloud PCs that use that connection will be able to provision successfully. So if I go to the hybrid Azure AD Join, you see I have a lot of tests and mostly passed. I guess we have one that's in a warning state. But you'll notice there's a couple buckets. There's some for first party app permissions. So again, just permissions on your subscription. You'll see that there are some related to IP address and network readiness. And then you'll see almost the last three at the bottom. You'll see the Active Directory domain, Active Directory domain join. And again, that very first one, the Azure AD device sync, these are very specific to domain join because with hybrid Azure AD join, we rely on these devices getting synced to Azure AD using Azure AD Connect. And now if we switch over to an Azure AD join connection, you'll notice that these checks aren't there. So if you take a look at that, as mentioned, those domain join ones aren't there. They don't need to be there. All we really care about with the Azure AD join network connection is that your network is ready, that there's enough IP address space, and that we have the right permissions. But again, nothing domain related. So this is where we think that even if you still need to bring your network, it's going to be a lot easier to create Cloud PCs on an Azure AD join network connection as opposed to a hybrid Azure AD join network connection. So now that we have a working Azure AD join network connection, we can actually go back to the provisioning policy and create a provision policy with this Azure AD Join network connection. So again, now that we have our Azure AD Join network connection and now that's passing, we can go ahead and create a provisioning policy using this network connection. So we're going to jump back into the Endpoint Manager portal and create that new policy. So if you remember from the episode, we created a sample provisioning policy using the new Azure AD Join technology, but using the Microsoft hosted network. In this scenario, now that we have a working successful Azure AD Join network connection, we're going to use that to create the policy, and that way you see the difference in the two flows. So I'm going to name this one Episode 6, Part 2, now that this is the bonus content, leave the description empty. But now I'll leave Azure AD Join selected, but instead of selecting the Microsoft Hosted Network, I'm going to expand that dropdown and select our Azure AD Join network connection. In this case, it's the West US 2, so I'm going to go ahead and select that. As you see, the region option goes away because now that you have your own network, it's already tied to a region, which I can tell from my network connection is West US 2. So after this, none of the steps really change after this. I'll walk through it just so you see, but if seeing is believing, we'll go through it. Again, we can just go ahead with the gallery image. Again, gallery images for Windows 10 or Windows 11, I'll choose Windows 11. In this case, for the language and region, again, I'm going to show you the dropdown, and I'm going to stick with English United States, but I do just want to show you that dropdown again of what options you have available. Again, I can add a group here if they're already licensed for Cloud PC, or I can come back to it later. But we're going to just, again, skip to the review and create. And just like that. From the main episode, we had Azure AD Join with the Microsoft Hosted Network. Here we have it with your own network connection. And so again, it's the provisioning policy creation process. Hopefully you also agree. I think it's fairly simple. But again, that flexibility, that way you can use the new join technology, the Azure AD Join technology, in whichever way you need for your organization. And that's all the content I have for you today. So thanks for joining. Hopefully this was informative and insightful, and hopefully you have the tools you need to really start creating Windows 365 Cloud PCs with the new Azure AD Join option. And so if you want to see the full episode, that's the Episode 6, Windows in the Cloud, Windows 365 Enterprise and Azure AD Join support. If you want to see our blog post and comment there, that's going to be on the Windows IT Pro tech community page. If you want to provide feedback or just follow me on social, on LinkedIn, search Christian Montoya, Microsoft. Again, thanks for joining and hope to see you all soon.